Well, hello, friends. The time is now just before 11 o'clock in the morning. Happy Saturday. So the time is now just before 11 o'clock. It is Saturday, April 2nd. And so it is my weekend off. And so, yes, I slept in today. And, well, not really, because this last few weeks now, the sunshine has been up early before 7 a.m. And because that's what it does here. It's like in the springtime, the sunshine comes out early. And even if I want to or not, I just wake up early. And so I've been just on the bed, like, watching other people's YouTube videos and vlogs and whatnot. And so, yeah. And so for today, for Saturday, I got really no plans to do anything, really. It's just later today, I plan to go out to the drugstore to get some vitamins to see if they have any vitamins on sale. Because it's just up the hill here, and I can walk there, and I'm too lazy to spend a bus ticket. And so, yeah. And also, yesterday Friday, for Payday Friday, I was wanting to order some Chinese takeout, but Matthew was helping his parents move, and I was home alone, and we have actually leftovers in the fridge, and so probably gonna leave that money for next week, because next week I've got several days off as well, and so gonna set aside some of the fun money. And so, yeah. And also, I want to set aside some money so I can go to the drum circle next Friday. And so that's about it that's going on for Saturday. And because Matthew says that his parents would be feeding him today because he's helping them move. And so I'm gonna save the barbecue chicken for tomorrow. And I'm gonna be doing a roast beef tonight instead. Gonna switch it up a bit. And guys, look at this gorgeous weather out there. Really, really warm. Gorgeous. Look at how gorgeous the weather is. So beautiful. And so, yeah. So today, not much other exciting things besides going to the drugstore. And yeah. And so for breakfast today, I think gonna be doing the leftovers. And I have been, for a few weekends now, I've been wanting to make the no-bake eclair cake recipe again. And I got the recipe idea from Meet the Presleys, Sarah and Josh. But the fridge seems to be keep on filling up, and I never have room in the fridge for that. And so, because it is a no-bake cake, and it's really, really good cake. And so, but I've got no room for that right now. So yeah, so hope you guys are having a lovely Saturday. Not much going on today, and I'll be seeing you guys in a little bit. Hey guys, so the time is now 10:45, and breakfast is served, and it is the leftover sweet and sour pork. And so I really, really do hope you guys check out that slow cooker recipe. I uploaded the vlog 1 or 2 days ago. And so it's a slow cooker sweet and sour pork recipe. It is very awesome. Also, the one thing that I was thinking about doing for Saturday is maybe going out to Saturday brunch or breakfast or something. But in the shopping center that is behind our house, we have such a big honkin' shopping center, and we are missing a place that sells breakfast things. Like, we do not have, like, Eggs Oasis or something. And the only thing that sells breakfast is Subway. They sell the omelet in the Subway. And so, that is very, very annoying. And so, Yeah, and so that's why I just decided to stay home for breakfast. And because, like I say, we got leftovers anyways. And yeah, so there it is. Leftovers for breakfast. All right, I'll zoom in to show you guys the color. Doesn't that look gorgeous? Oh my gosh, guys, look at all this junk mail that's been collecting. And it's like, the time is almost 1:02 and I have done totally nothing for Saturday. And so I'm just finishing up watching a ghost show. And then probably I want to be heading out. And so, yeah. Don't you like my beautiful, beautiful fan of junk mail? I got junk mail fan. Yeah. All right, guys. Junk mail. All right. This one is one of my favorite ghost hunters. Here. Like that girl there. And, she is one of the British ones, like the Yvette Fielding, her name is. But, I don't think they make any more new episodes because, this one is from 2003. And so, yeah, so it's really, really old stuff. So, yeah. And so I said I finished watching another ghost show, but then there's another one on. And so I guess I'm never going to be leaving the house then. Ha! I lied. So she does have a new one. The Most Haunted, the Yvette Fielding. She did this one back in April. 2016, April. So there is new ones for her. And so also I would like to update. These things here are really, really good. This is the honey roasted peanuts. And so, for those of you who are asking, yes, Matthew, let me have some, of course, or else he's gonna get smacked if he doesn't. So, yeah, all right. Hey guys, so now I'm finally out and about the house. Just past 3 o'clock. And if you guys can hear it, the weather things say it's 19 degrees still, but it got really gray and chilly and windy a bit. But that's okay because it's nice to cool down a little bit. Because yesterday, for my standards, it was way too hot yesterday, and that was just the first day of it. And so, yeah. All right, guys, just headed up to the drugstore now. I just don't get it. Like, all of these are new houses. Like, all the houses in this area is about the same amount of years old. I don't know why they need to fix their sign already. Crazy stuff. Hey guys, so the time is now almost 4 o'clock, and boy did it get blustery windy out there. And like, even inside the drugstore, you can hear the wind howling inside. And so, it was like a ghost show almost. And so, Boy, oh boy, today the drugstore was useless, and usually they are really well stocked in the freezer stuff because the drugstore is bought by Loblaws, so they always sell the President's Choice stuff or the no-name stuff or whatever, but this time the stuff they stocked the freezer with is useless stuff that I don't need or like. And so I was wanting to buy some freezer stuff, but I didn't. And so let me show you the shopping that I did. And so I got my favorite dark ginger ale. And this was dirt cheap because I used the $2 coupon that I got from last time, so it only cost $1.49. And then I bought this, my favorite childhood snack, these rice crackers, but they seem to have gotten way, way, way smaller than I remember them to be, and so, yeah. And then I bought a thing of calcium for me, and then I bought a thing of vitamin C, and the vitamin C, when I start the new round, I am actually gonna knock down the dosage from 1,000 to 500 because I read here and there that too much vitamin C is no good for your body anyways. And so, yeah. And then also, I got a thing of this Avia Instant Starbucks because lately everywhere, the Tassimo has not been on sale, and the Tassimo has been very useless lately. And so I'm like, F Tassimo, and I just bought some coffee because I'm low on coffee. And then I got a thing of this, our favorite soap, the body wash that we use. It was on sale, so I bought that. This is the one that we like to use, because that brand of soap hasn't been on sale for a long time. So yeah, just stocking up on some body wash. And so yeah. And so today's shopping was only just $37 again. Like yesterday I spent $38 and today I spent $37. Oh my gosh, right guys? Crazy! And so today's weather turned out to be perfect for roast beef, actually. All right, guys, I'll be getting ready to make my roast beef soon. Hey, guys, so the time is almost 5:00 and Matthew is still helping his parents move. And so it looks like it's going to be a home alone dinner for me. And so it's going to be a roast beef dinner for one. And so too bad for Matthew. And so this is my nice honkin' size roast beef that I got here. And so I marinated it with my usual spice blend, which is salt, pepper, garlic powder, and onion powder. That's my favorite go-to blend for my roast dinners. And so what I first do is I put it uncovered for about 10 minutes, 400 degrees to get the roast beef nice and crispy up, and then I knock the temperature down back to 375 degrees for the remaining of the cook time. So there you guys go. Oh, it's heavy. There you go. And so later on I'll be working on the potatoes. All right. So now the 10 minutes at 400 degrees is up. Do you guys see how nice and little bit crusty the top got? So that's what I'm after. So now I'm just gonna cover it. And I actually knocked the temperature down to 350. And it's gonna be the rest of the gonna be the rest of the cooking process. All right. Hey guys, the time is almost 6 o'clock, and then I got our potatoes going on. And so every time I show this machine, there is always some people that is amazed by it. And so this one here is actually the old one. That is the first generation of the Tefal Active Fry, and you can get it at the good old Bed Bath & Beyond, and they now have a few different models of this thing already. And the good thing about this Tefal Active Fry is that it only takes one spoon of oil. And so nowadays though, there is many different models of air fryers out there, so there's a lot of choices, but this one was given to us as a gift, so that's very nice. And so yeah, just putting in the potatoes. All right guys. Hey guys, so the roast beef took way too long. It's probably because this roast beef is a bit bigger chunk, and so it took slightly over an hour. Because for the roast beef, for the beef that I eat, I do not like my beef too bloody. Like, I do not like running blood on my plate. And so right now, according to this temperature thing, it says it is around medium well. So I've been testing it on and off for about 10-15 minutes now. And so yeah, I'm just gonna make gravy now, and dinner will be ready. And the potatoes are ready there. So yeah, this roast took a little bit longer than I thought it would. All right. Wow, you guys, look at this. It actually turned out perfect. It's like well cooked around the edges and just a little bit of pink in the middle. Wow, wow, wow. It turned out perfect. And Matthew is missing out on this dinner. Beautiful. All right, guys. Picture perfect. Hey, guys. So the time is now 7:30, and dinner is finally served. And so the most annoying part of today's dinner is making the gravy, because Matthew is not here. And so I'm stuck with the gravy. And so that is as good my gravy will get. And so here is the plate of the roast beef dinner today. And those are the rainbow carrots. I hope you guys can see the rainbow carrots there. They look really pretty. And there's the potatoes and the roast beef. So yeah. So right now there's not much diddly squat nothing on TV right now, except for some ghost shows. And hopefully you guys enjoy to hang out with me today. And I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow. All right. Hope you guys are having a lovely weekend.